Hi, this is John from Gadget Road, and today I'm gonna take you through a quick look of the Lenovo X220 Ultra Portable. It's a 12.5-inch laptop. It's one of the lightest on the market today. It's very, very powerful. Unlike the MacBook Airs launched a few days ago, they use full size and full voltage Core i3 through Core i7 CPUs. And the battery lasts a lot longer. Sure, they are not as thin and not as light as the MacBook Airs, but comparing the performance you're getting, I say it's worth it. So, my unit here, it's a top spec Core i7 model. It's a dual core, 2.7 GHz up to 3.4 via Intel Turbo Boost. I got the 9-cell battery that sticks out of the back. Total weight, it's 1.7 kilograms, which is roughly 3.76 pounds, so it's very, very light, considering I got everything on it. It even has dual hard drives. One is the normal 7200 RPM hard drive, 7mm thick. That's a problem if you want to upgrade it. But I also got an Intel mSATA SSD, 80 gigs, that fits inside the W1 module. It's not that easy to assemble, but especially if you're not purchasing it from Lenovo, but it gets the job done. You can do it in a few minutes, and the performance boost by using an SSD drive, it's amazing. Let's take a look at the ports. I'm gonna start with the left side. There are some vents, USB 3.0, available only with the Core i7 model. This is the VGA out. Display port out. It supports higher resolutions, like for 30-inch screens, for example. USB 2.0. It's a wireless toggle switch and express card 34mm slot. On the front, there's nothing. Only some speakers, very, very small speakers. Volume is not satisfactory, as you'll encounter if you get one. But it's a business laptop, so not really a problem. On the right side, we have an SD card slot. It's capable of reading SXHD cards, so you get over 22 gigabytes cards, but they are still expensive. It's a power on USB port, that's why it's yellow. You can set it up to charge your phone, tablet or something when the laptop is powered off, not just in standby. Ethernet jack. This is the headphone jack. This is the bay for the 77mm hard drive. Kensington lock. Let's switch to the back. A huge 9-cell battery. The AC adapter port and another vent. If you turn it over, you can see what I'm talking about, the 9-cell battery. It is big, adds to the weight, but it also provides up to 7 hours of real life usage. I'm using, and by real life usage, I'm talking about watching Flash movies, even doing some Photoshop work, some video encoding. With normal use or moderate use, you can get at least 10 hours of battery life. I'm sure of that. If you want to upgrade the memory, you can do it very easily. You have to remove two screws, and you have two slots here that accept DDR3 memory. One screw here unlocks the hard drive. As I said, it's a 7mm high hard drive. Normally, notebook hard drives are 9.5mm, so the offer is pretty limited today. Let's get back to the inside for a minute. Oh, one more thing. There's no display latch. It's only a lip here. You can put your finger and open up the display. Inside you have the gorgeous ThinkPad keyboard. Now it's available on in the same full size as you get on the 14-inch, 15-inch and 17-inch ThinkPad laptops. It's not a chiclet keyboard, it's the regular one. It features the award-winning Lenovo trackpad. It also has a click pad here. We with integrated buttons. It doesn't work as well, but you'll see that in my future videos. I got a fingerprint reader. It's very interesting because you can power on the laptop from the fingerprint. You just swipe it and the laptop recognizes your finger from the BIOS and boots up and even logs in into Windows without you touching the keyboard. There's a row of special buttons brought by Lenovo. Mute button, volume up, down, microphone mute, sync vantage button launches up Lenovo's business suite of apps. Some of them are very, very interesting. They are complementing Windows 7 very well, and the power button here. It's of no use for me as I'm using the fingerprint reader. There are some few status LEDs, I don't know if I should call them LEDs. The wireless one, Bluetooth, hard drive activity. And when you close it on the back, you have two more here. One it shows that the battery is charging or it's in action, and the one is the sleep status indicator. Now one more thing, the Lenovo X220 comes with a 65 watt hour charger. It's very, very, very small. Let's compare it to my 4-inch Samsung Galaxy S. It's very it doesn't get too hot, and it charges the 9-cell battery in around 3 hours, which is very, very well compared to my my previous Sony Vaio, which charged a 9-cell battery in 5.5 hours. So you won't get wired too much waiting for the battery to charge. One more thing I want to show you. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous IPS screen. It's IPS like in the iPad, which means great to excellent viewing angles. Excellent brightness. Lenovo says it's 300 nits, but reviewers all over the web said they are around 270. It's very, very bright even at lower settings, as you can see. There's only one time when you can't see it, which is when it's in the first 3-4 steps. After that, it's very, very easy to see it. Viewing angles are really great. It's a matte display, so this means it's very good for outdoor working. Now one more thing, let's compare the Lenovo ThinkPad in size with an iPad to get an idea how big this thing is. 12.5 inches, as I said, in diagonal, and the iPad is 9.7, so the difference is it's not that much, only in width, as you can see. That's it for today. I'm gonna shoot other videos for Gadget Road with the Lenovo X220. I'm gonna try and show you boot times, the special software, and how it works with games and general applications. Thank you, and don't forget to read the Lenovo X220 review on Gadget Road. Bye.